remind you that we have a very fine speaker before we get to give the certificates. So thank you. So our speakers for the undergraduate certificate, we're very proud to introduce Jake Halsey, and Karen Boger has a few things to say about Jake.
When Jake first came to UCSB, he was interested in economics, surfing, and swimming. He discovered two new passions at UCSB, rowing and the technology management program. He had never rowed before he came to college, but he tried it here, and he liked it, and he committed to it. Jake and the UCSB rowing team won the U.S. National Championships in Varsity 8. And then Jake and two other teammates were then invited to participate in the USA U23 rowing team. Jake also discovered TMP in his freshman year. He took TMP 21, which is the past, present, and future of entrepreneurship. He was hooked. He then took TMP 111, the Distinguished Speaker Series. He liked it so much that he attended that class every semester after the first one. This year, he also competed in a new venture competition. He and his partner developed an autonomous exterior sprinkler system to protect households, homes, and wildfires. Obviously, a very timely and compelling value proposition. I asked several of Jake's instructors to describe him. They described him as soulful, mature, and determined. But one comment from John Greathouse really stood out. He said, Jake's future is so bright that he will need a durable pair of sunglasses. So congratulations to Jake, and he will share now his perspective.
So if I get choked up, that's why. No other reason. Good morning, TMP graduates. It is an exciting day for all of us, as each one of us has made it through the technology management program and are receiving our certificate today. Now, who are we? We are the future builders and creators of ideas that are going to transform the world we live in. Each one of us has been given the knowledge, relationships, and opportunity to transform other people's lives and organizations we are a part of or that we have created. Now I want to ask all of you, does the world need transforming?
Yeah.
Absolutely. I want you to look around. That graduate sitting next to you could be the next one who initiates the next big change in the world. I'd like to share some stories from my transformational journey here at UCSB and some of the valuable lessons I learned and understood from these experiences. I was a member of the UCSB rowing team for 3 years. I'd never rowed before college, but decided on my first day to just try it out. I was not someone who just did something like this, so I'm not sure why I chose to join, but what came out of it was much more than what I thought possible. I made great friendships and learned about teamwork, dedication, and determination. As a team, we were trained together for many hours each week, working to prepare ourselves for the upcoming races. I had a great amount of respect for all of my teammates because of the hard work they put in. An important transformative moment occurred for me during my time as a rower. At the end of my sophomore year, the national championship race was fast approaching. This was a race that would test our mental and physical abilities like no other race. We'd been well prepared by hundreds of hours of training at times where most were sleeping. Before I knew it, the race was upon us. As the race began, I remember being filled with emotions. Those of hunger for victory, nerves for defeat, and excitement for the race. We had a good start to our race, which is an advantage as we got an early lead. After half the race had passed, our boat was sitting in second place. I had noted what my team had gone through to prepare, and I trusted each one of my teammates to put down their very best race. As the finish line fast approached, I began to hear the chants from a crowd of a steady UCSB, which ignited a new drive that made us all push harder. As the race finished, our bow crossed the finish line just 1 second after the first place team. We lost the national title by 1 second over a 6 minute race. Our very best performance was just shy of a national title. But what came out of this race was much more than feelings of failure and disappointment. We were proud of what we had done as a team. At this time, this was the best UCSB finish had ever obtained. We saw what great training and great coaching could do. Rather than being discouraged from this loss, we decided to make that moment a learning opportunity. What would it take for us to be 1 second faster the following year? Our team was resilient and trained daily the following year with memories of that race in the back of our mind. It was just 1 year after our second place finish that UCSB won its first national title. Failure is by no means the end of something you are passionate about. There will be countless moments in life where failure may occur, and that is perfectly fine. There may be times where your best might not feel good enough at that particular moment. It's not failure that is important, but what you can do to learn from it. Failure is an opportunity. Failure is a chance to look back on what you did and decide how you can change the future to make a better outcome. Now I'd like you to think of the classes we have all taken in TMP and how they have given us many opportunities to fail and learn from them. We were put in competitions against other students where there would only be one winner. Competitions like Captain, where we would try to manage our company's marketing and finances. And sometimes in those competitions, we fail, like getting an emergency loan in the second round, which might have been my fault. Or somehow taking goods out of recycled materials and trying to sell them. In many of our classes, we've been taught how to fail and be resilient. Each failure contributed to doing better on the next task. Each one of us has been transformed by TMP. The program has taught us how to learn from our choices so that we can be stronger for tasks ahead. At the end of fall quarter, I received a job offer to work at a respected financial firm, and I thought my job worries would be taken care of. Now I thought maybe I could take schoolwork a bit easier now that I was confident about my future. But there was still one thing I wanted to do. The new venture competition was something that had interested me since my freshman year, but I'd never just chose to follow through. My senior year, I decided, why not say yes? I asked my friend Randall if he wanted to join, and we were both in. This one decision on a Friday afternoon completely transformed what I thought I wanted to do with my life. After we enrolled in TMP 148 to help prepare us for the new venture competition, I declined my job offer to go full into creating a business. Throughout the experience, we were exposed to all aspects of starting a business. We created an exterior autonomous sprinkler system that would significantly reduce the risk of home burning down in the event of a wildfire. Through research, we were able to talk to individuals across the world about our idea. We were taught by great teachers on what steps to take to make this idea viable. Without TMP, none of this would have been possible. We have all been given the opportunity to learn from individuals who have took the initiative and said yes. Our professors shared their stories with us and are living proof that success comes with this drive to take initiative and say yes. Opportunities are all around us because of our experience in TMP. Throughout our time in the program, we've listened to many speakers who have had failures or plans that did not go the way they wanted. But these speakers said yes to trying again and let failure just be a part of their journey, guiding them to creating innovative organizations. We've had amazing, accomplished professors who have challenged us to try new experiences, knowing that every time we stretch our capabilities, we maximize our possibilities. Even after our time here is done, the opportunities do not stop. When an opportunity comes your way, I'm asking you to take it. There might be some options that seem scary, like moving away or doing something you have never done before. But as someone who gave a small opportunity a try, like the new venture competition, it's important to realize that rising to new challenges can help you create an outstanding life. As a final thought, I'd like to take you to one of the most memorable moments of my college career. It happened during that last race I described earlier. A few words were said by my coxswain, or as the rest of the world knows him, that little guy in the front of the boat that yells a lot. But during our final race, he told us that we stand on the shoulders of giants, and that this race was bigger than us. We were not just racing for those in the boat that day. but all of those who came before us. Those words inspired me more than any other words I'd heard before. It was those who trained before us who built up the foundation high enough so that we could achieve feats even greater than what they had. For us in the Technology Management Program, we too stand on the shoulders of giants. The shoulders of Greathouse, Stotts, Trigg, and many more. We are here today thanks to those who came before us and the contributions and choices they have made. Throughout our college education, they have been giving us the knowledge and preparing us to stand in their place. Today marks the beginning of a transformation for us all. Today we step off the shoulders of those who have given us so much. We are now about to set off on a journey. Many of us away from here, no longer surrounded by our peers. We are now free to make our own choices and choose our own paths. It is now our turn to build up our own foundations and grow as individuals. May we be the new giants whose shoulders are stood upon by the future students of the Technology Management Program. Let us be the speakers who inspire students to take on great challenges, leverage failures, and say yes to opportunities. I'd like to thank those giants in my life who have given me so much. To my mom, dad, and brother who have supported me my whole life. To friends, both domestic and international, who have made college exciting. To the teachers and staff of TMP who have taught not only me, but all of us, the lessons and skills needed to lead a successful life. And lastly, I'd like to thank each one of the graduates here tonight. You are the ones who I've gone through this incredible journey with. Each one of you contains a drive and a passion that I looked up to during my time here at UCSB. Although our time here as undergraduates may be over, our journey to transform the world has just begun. Thank you.
Now we now have the individuals receiving the undergraduate certificate.